all of you to know, I accept challenges because I want to be the best. I put 100% of my energy into everything I do, from G-Unit sneakers to RBK, from Formula 50 vitamin water, to Pontiac G6, to G-Unit clothing line, my line of books and video games. I'm passionate about making sure all my products succeed in the marketplace. I incorporate all my products into my lifestyle, from music to videos to concerts, into everything 50 Cent.
Can you tell us who exactly the scientist is that this one is not hot? The only person who's not actually trying to do it right now is Lloyd. So, Lloyd Banks, Tony Yayo, Young Buck,
for Fifth, me and you and Banks. They want to know, what do we think about the Sean Bell case? Whoever want to answer first. I think it's up.
I mean, we're from Southside Jamaica, so we know the price of life is cheap there. It's obvious, it shows you, even in that space, that, you know, like, and they ask you who run New York, because the Rikers Island is predominantly occupied by Bloods. Some people might say Bloods, but for damn sure the Crips run it, but we mean the Boys in Blue. Mm-hmm. We mean NYPD, and they can get away with murder. It's obvious. Like, how the fuck can you justify shooting somebody 50 times that doesn't have a weapon?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? There's no way that you can do that. And then if the district attorney's office didn't present a good enough case, who did the police work with more often? They work with the district attorney's office to create convictions.
I felt like we had to recondition people didn't enjoy what we done originally. Mm-hmm. You know, so to get them back and into that mold and start to actually condition ourselves to do the right things musically too. Mm-hmm. You know, so we got in there and we had a good time making actual material. For the most part, it was like, it was happening fast, like it was organic, mm-hmm. the whole thing. Like, we back, that's in our comfort zone. Like, you know what I mean? That's just what we initially started. Like, there's no, we don't have to say anything to anybody about getting that done. Like, we get in there, like, we do a part, you come out, they do this, they do this, we move to the next one. It's 100, and we kind of been able to surpass what we've done previously based on the new material that we put out, because they've grown as artists at the same time. I'm growing, I'm in a different space, and we've been able to just conceptually gel together a lot easier.
Okay. Now, will that carry over to the new project, Terminate On Sight?
Oh yeah. Like, I mean, the actual album, there's points where Banks offered material that I thought was like smoking hot. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, yo, this is crazy right here. Like, I just gotta put my part at the end because y'all already did this. You see what I'm saying? Like, and then I got at the end of the record because it killed it. Like, sir, a good portion of creating good music is having things that are being said on the record said at the right point. So if he's saying something in his verse that's so crazy, like, I'm like, listen, that gotta be the opening statement. Like, that gotta be the first thing they hear. And we just go from there. Like, regardless to who said it, whether it was Yayo or Banks at that point. I mean, it's just, he has a consistency of delivering that line. Like, he thinks that way. You know what I mean? Like, so, for us, it's the actual topic and lifestyle. It's more like, from Yeah, You'll Get, like, his last album was Thoughts of a Predicate Felon. He can bring forth a mentality and an attitude in his music that I couldn't actually reach. I couldn't get there. You know, because we didn't experience the same things. He's fresh from those experiences, you know, coming right into that. And then, and Banks' wit as a rap artist and a writer, one of the hottest out there, I believe.
If it's looking good, I'm gonna let it come up. And when the sun comes down, I'll be back in the town. Smash box down with the back in the pack. Come on, the cheese in the cup. Sick to get. They are not falling on the cheese to get. Have everything you want handy for your DVD. OEE on the CD. Sneak.
Banks, how do you feel about the Terminate On Sight project? How's everything coming along?
It's exciting, man. I feel the same way about this project now. You know, same way I felt with Beg for Mercy and every other album. It's all exciting, whether it's my album, group album, 50 album, Yayo album, same run.
The anticipation is ill. You know what's crazy? I'm gonna tell you your biggest misconception, right? The biggest thing that people mistake about us is they think, because the project's an individual project, that it's not an effort from all of us to make it a successful project, right? If it's my album, it's hot, so what, we go tour, make millions of dollars touring and doing what we're doing in order to, not just for 50 Cent, but for the whole camp, because they be physically available to go to those different markets to create a presentation that allows people to come based on the new projects that we put out, like based on Curtis or The Massacre or Give It To Die Trying, he gets a chance to expose themselves to that audience and then come back with The Hunger For More and Rotten Apple. You know, so I think they look at it and they go, oh, this is this album, so we should be interested. Nah, you should be interested in everything that we're doing.
Now, why'd you go with the title Terminate On Sight?
I mean, it's a sequel. It's a sequel to Beg For Mercy. Like, when we told the competition and the other artists from the creative level to Beg For Mercy, yeah. Then we went from Beg For Mercy to Terminate On Sight. You know what I mean? And it's more like, it's an aggressive title that would allow us still being acceptable and presentable on all fronts. listen, you already know. I know who he gonna look at in this room. How do I know who you was gonna look at in this room? That means he was thinking about it. He said he personally didn't look, right? That means he was thinking about it, right?
Damn right.
He was thinking about it.
Personal issues as far as like, you know, the situation with your baby mother or like the situations you have on record with other rappers, do you think that it's gonna overshadow the new project?
Absolutely not. I think the music speaks for itself.
Alright, now you have one more album on the inner store.
Yeah.
To do out in November, right?
Yep.
You wanna speak on it real quick?
Before Self-Destruct. This album has like a direct concept to it, so you know, it's like, it wasn't like I started recording that before I did Curtis. You know what I mean? So I've been working on it in pieces while creating the things that we've been creating for T.O.S, Terminate On Sight. Now that'll be out, that's the focus. Later on in November, I'll release music. But by then, I've been made so much new music material. Because my music is dated to me. Like, I enjoy it, I'm listening to it, and then I got new ideas. Constantly have new ideas, so I go back in and just work. Like, what was it, this weekend we made 4 new records, you know, we wrote 4 new songs, and it's like, that's cool, but you know, we're going back again throughout the week to continue recording up until Friday, okay, you know, so we just keep making music. Like, if you have a passion for it and you actually, you know, want to be the best you can actually be as far as the general public is concerned, so they embrace it.
What can we expect on the third solo project, or when can we expect
it? I never stopped recording. Even in event what I was going through, I still recorded before I actually got back into the public eye. But they can expect a lot of energy. I just felt like the label at that time, they were trying to like make me something like so
different.
Yeah, like put me out there in a whole nother way and telling me how big they envisioned me, but didn't connect. You know, like I wrote an album for a big, heavy, like feature album, and a lot of features didn't take place, and like, it didn't happen the right way. So this album is more like for my core, because it's to the point where it's like, nah, I'd rather go, you know, giving my fans, my hardcore street mixtape face, what they want to hear. And especially at a time like this where it's going back to what you actually say. For the last couple of years, it's been about your dance moves and your slang. And, you know, but when it, and people complain when it comes back to that time where you actually get credit for being a lyricist. And, you know, that's why I step up, and they can expect my mixtape game to continue even after the junior album comes out.
On my way to Angola.
Crazy.
Yo, what's up? It's your boy 50 Cent coming at you live from Australia. Lloyd Banks, DJ Whoo Kid. My stylist Mia in the background is going down. We're in the Versace Hotels, on one hotel on the planet, completely made by Versace. Look over there, you see the emerald. Just coming at the emerald. Everything here is made by Versace. Everything. Versace Rose right there. His and hers, I'm gonna steal those. I'm rich, but I'm taking those anyway. Take that to the house, right?
He went out last night while we all were sitting.
The door's open? Oh,
yeah, that's open. Hey, look at
it. Go watch this.
Underworld, man, get out of here.
You get y'all back.
Hold on. Y'all heard about this.
That's a bull. This ain't supposed to be me, man. It's supposed to be Banks, man. Yeah, I'm getting my revenge on y'all, I promise, man.
Everything was like totally different. We went from riding around in a Dodge Caravan to Banks having all these big rings and stuff like that coming to see me in jail.
He said he came out of jail.
He came to see
he
me
went back in 12 hours.
They came to see me and stuff. So. But the transition, just seeing, I mean, everything was just crazy. I mean, like, the records, I remember 50 didn't even like Many Men. That was like a record we used to listen to.
I didn't like that record at the house.
Really?
Yeah, you didn't like it.
You know what it was? Like, I wrote so many records that I was feeling like the tempo didn't need to go down at all on Get Rich or Die Trying. And that record was emotional. It meant something to me, but it was just slower than P.I.M.P. and In the Club and Back Down and the other joints that was there. So at that point, I had this thing where I was like, yo, I just want the record to just
just
hit the whole way, and it's just the whole thing is like.
But that's a record that like I picked.
A blood rushing.
Like, yo, you gotta put that out. Like, you gotta put that on the album.
And after he came up, after he said that, I took that in and put the record on there, and then created 21 Questions. You know, so those were the two records that had the slower tempo on Get Rich or Die Trying. But if they physically wasn't around to give their opinions at that point, Get Rich or Die Trying might have been something different. Magic's there. On Lil' Kim's album, that was written for Get Rich or Die Trying. So those records, like, each one of those records could have been different based on just little things happening in a time period. Imagine what The Massacre would have been. Like, the record sold 9.8 million records.
This is how we do
and Hate It, I Love It, to add to the hit records that were there. Because of that, I mean, I've accomplished being the only rapper that can actually say they were compared to the Beatles for having four records in the top 10 at the same time. And that was because two of them was on Game's album that I wrote, and two of them was on my album that I wrote. Kid 50 Cent, we're in the airport right now, JFK Airport. We're going to go on an international run. First flight is about 20 hours. We're going to take you on the whole international run. You're going to get a chance to talk to me. Everybody's going to be here in a second. They ain't all get here yet. Of course, I'm here first. I'm always the first one. Everywhere we got to go, last one to sleep when we're working. Got to get the job done. You understand what I'm saying? So you're going to get a chance to get everything. You're going to get a chance to go through step by step what it's like to be on an international run. For short, though, we're only going to be out for about 17 days, and you get a chance to check us out.
You know what I'm saying? I never seen a kangaroo in my life. I'm going to go to Africa and kill me a tiger. Tell me what you're talking
about. It's my last day at work. I don't give a if I get fired for Jesus.
What's up with your point 50 Cent? We out here in Sydney, Australia. Day one of the actual international tour. It's not a long run. We're only going to be out for about 17 days. We're going to have a ball. You can see the backdrop of Australia behind us. The city is definitely going down. We're having a good time out here.
Fat DJs need to work out. Stop being fat and sloppy.
We're in the gym. I'm staying in the hotel gym. Getting ready for the family going tonight. It's going down. About 11,000 people. The venue on the road, 11,000 people. So. working with tonight. We actually got a chance to move here from the same plane. Even them is out there.
Yeah, Eve is on. She's on fire.
Yeah, folks in the same plane with us. So
shout to Eve.
We ran in the house, can't shout to Eve. Man, we're getting it together.
Gotta get it right, baby. See you what?
I expect a big response. You know, I'm receiving a big response now. Like, we have material that we made on the mixtape. Like, Body Part 2 turned into a record.
Smash.
It's like, organically, it does something in the nightclubs right now. The other records that out ain't doing that. Not without the support of the record companies and marketing dollars we spent on it. So, without that, when you see that response, it should indicate to you that you should actually go after that.
No, I don't want to talk about that right now.
Tell the stories. Tell the stories.
That said, Papi.
I called my father, but that's
a different story. How old is your father?
I don't know, 50-something.
Your name is called Pops, right? What did you call your father again?
Papi.
Papi. He said he tried to call everybody. Nobody picked on his father. So his father changed like, so his father had a shotgun.
What do you have, yo?
He had a broomstick. And then he said, we do weird stuff when we buy.
Wow, so?
He named his kids off of video game characters.
Oh, that's really their name for real?
Yes, Ken and Ryu. Stop
playing. Ken and Ryu.
It's a coincidence.
I need a dollar every time that my heart beats. Now how much is that? I can breathe on the track and make money. Yeah, yeah. Now how much you want? I'm getting money, baby. My truck a Lamborghini. I'm in an Lamborghini. We can press a freaky. Ain't it for the city? F***ing see me. But I love it when you lie and say my eyes are dreamy. Certain niggas fall in love with them tricks. Patrolling my
me coming from where I'm from, like coming from straight out of prison to being in living in the middle of Manhattan. One condo, me and Banks have another condo and 333 Rector Place right here. That's real, right next to the Twin Towers. That's, you know what I mean? Like, these are my dreams that I'm in. So I vision, you know, us selling and doing records, but I never seen it being this big.
Hey, what's up? Yo, it's the kid 50 Cent.
And it's your boy Lloyd Banks.
And it's the talk of New York, Tony Yayo.
And as you see, this is the Chit 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 Unit.